السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. I'm your host عبد العزيز الحسن and we are going to continue our trip through the interpretation of the verses related to Ramadan in the Quran. So we start with the history of the fasting. We have mentioned previously that the fasting in the era of Rasulullah in the beginning and the prophets before them was between Isha and Maghrib. And then later on it was from Fajr, from Maghrib until Fajr. That's why Allah Azza wa Jalla says in this ayah, فَكُلُوا وَاشْرَبُوا حَتَّى يَتَبَيَّنَ لَكُمْ الْخَيْطُ الْأَبْيَضُ مِنَ الْخَيْطِ الْأَسْوَدِ مِنَ الْفَجْرِ. So drink and eat until the white thread is different from the black thread of Fajr. In the beginning of the revelation, there was not that word which is of Fajr, the dawn time. And because of that, one of the well-known companions, his name is Adi ibn Hatib al-Ta'i, radiallahu anhu. His father is a renowned, generous man of Arabs, but he did not catch up with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he had under his pillow, he said, I took, this is his narrative, he said, I took two threads, iqal, like robes, one black and the other is white. And I put those under my pillow. He was sleeping maybe outside, and he said, I was looking until I saw that there's a difference between the white and black from the beginning of the shining of the Fajr. And then after that, what I did is I stopped breakfasting, I started fasting. And he came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he told him, when I did that, I started fasting. Rasulullah said, wow, your pillow is so large because it is covering the whole horizon, meaning that it's not the threads or the robes that he's putting under his pillow, it's the Fajr threads, the white and the black. And that's why Allah Azza wa Jal has revealed the word of Fajr. فَكُلُوا وَاشْرَبُوا حَتَّى يَتَبَيَّنَ لَكُمْ الْخَيْطُ الْأَبْيَضُ مِنَ الْخَيْطِ الْأَسْوَدِ مِنَ الْفَجْرِ, out of Fajr. And now we see how big is the time that we can fast and we break our fast. It's from Maghrib to Fajr rather than from Maghrib to Isha like it used to be earlier. And this also shows to us that it is recommended for us to eat and drink until Fajr. And before Fajr, there is the Suhoor. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because of the history of that matter, he said, "Aklatu suhoor, the breakfast. I'm sorry, the suhoor itself is the difference between us and the people of the book, because the people of the book used to fast right away, maybe after Isha. So this makes a difference between the history of fasting with the people of the book and our way of fasting. Rasulullah sallam used to say, "Tasahharu fa inna fi suhoori baraka. Break your fast, eat the." Suhoor, for the suhoor itself is a blessing. And Rasulullah also said, my ummah is going to be all right as long as they hasten the breakfast and delay the suhoor. And Rasulullah said and recommended us to make to have the meal of suhoor, whether in food or even if we cannot make it, then it could be water. And he said there's a barakah and blessing upon that, and that Allah and his angels are invoking the peace and blessings upon those who eat the suhoor meal. ثُمَّ أَتِمُّ الصِّيَامَ إِلَى اللَّيْلِ, and then you continue your fasting until night, which is the other day, Maghrib. Once the iftar time comes, then we should break our fast. Rasulullah ﷺ, by the way, used to continue sometimes until maybe Isha or later on. But for us, the sunnah is to break our fast as soon as we hear the adhan of the Maghrib. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us our iftar and our siyam. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.